Hello everyone, so again I am here to teach you SST Standard 4 lecture number 2. So in this video we will start from the Jute topic page number 59. So if you don't have the book then please purchase it as soon as possible. So I am going to read the topic and then I will explain you, so you also read with me. So jute is used to make carpets, bags, ropes, etc. So jute is what? It can help to make the carpet which we usually used to kept in ground of our room. We use that bags, like we just use the hanging the bags, or like ropes is there. So with these all it can make with the jute. So jute is helps to make these all things. In fact, it needs plenty of water and a hot climate. So we can grow jute in the plenty of water and a hot climate. So it grows well in some states like West Bengal, Bihar, Assam and Odisha. Jute, it can grow in these states well. Now next topic is about the cotton. Cotton is used to make cloths, exactly which we use to wear in summer seasons. So with the help of cotton cloth, with the help of cotton is just helps to use the cotton cloth. So it used to make the cloth also which we wear in summer season. It grows well in a warm and dry climate. So cotton crops, it needs the climate, a warm and a very dry climate. So it can grow well in a warm and in a dry climate. In black soil or alluvium soil, so the cotton cloth, it can grow into two types, so in only two soils, in black soils or in alluvium soil. So some are the states which producing the cotton, like states are like Gujarat, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh and Punjab. These all are the states, cotton producing states. Next, in cash crops we have oil seeds. Now oil seeds are seeds from which oil can be extracted. Oil seed is what? It is a seeds from which the oils can be extracted. The oils which we are using to make the oils, different types of oils like the vegetable oils, then the coconut oils. So these all we can get from the oil seeds. So the groundnut, mustard, lime seed, sunflower and sesame seeds are the different kinds of oil seeds grow in India. These all are the different types of oil seeds which can grow in India and which we can use in these all oil which we can use in different types, in different times. Like the groundnuts is there, mustard oil, lime seeds, sunflower and seeds. These all are the seeds which it can produce the different types of oil. And they grow well in warm climate and moderate rainfall. And the oil seeds, these all are the oil seeds, it can grow in a warm climate with a very moderate rainfall. Next phase about the tea. It is also a cash crop. So we can know that in like many, if you can see the any movies or sometimes then you can see that phase, it is what? It is grows in the hilly areas. Plantation is on the hilly areas. So the tree grows well in the hilly regions of Assam, West Bengal and Tamil Nadu. So tree, it is a plantation tree which a single crops are there grow, which grow single crops. So tree is what? It also grow in the hilly areas, hills areas where the table land is there, and in states of Assam, West Bengal and Tamil Nadu. It requires a warm and wet climate. So to grow the tree crops, we need a warm and a wet climate. India is the world's second largest producer of tea after China. So first of all, the China is the largest producer of tea, but after the China, India is in second number in the world's in the world's second largest producer of tea. So please underline it that India is the world's, last second line, that India is the world's second largest in the world, world's second largest producer of tea after China. China is in the first number and second. India is the second in the whole world. It is the second largest producer of tea. Next, about the, it is also coffee and it is also cash crop. So, coffee is mostly grown in Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Coffee, it can grown in these three states, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. It requires a cool weather and heavy rainfall. To grow the coffee, it requires the cool weather and then heavy rainfall. You can see the ripening coffee beans. It the green is there, then after it can changes into red beans, and then it can, we just dry it in the sun, in the with the help of sunlights, and then after it can mix a cocoa powder, and then we can use it in a coffee to make some coffees. Next is spices. In spices there are different types of spices like cloves, cardamom, pepper, chilies, ginger, turmeric. So different types of spices is there, which we usually used in our food to make the food spicy. So spices grown in India, spices it also grown in India, spices like cloves, cardamom, pepper, chilies and ginger. These are the mostly grown in Kerala and Karnataka, where the climate is suitable and rainfall is heavy. These all are the spices, it can grown mostly in states Kerala and Karnataka, where the climate is suitable for to growing these spices and where the rainfall is heavy. Then we can grow these all crops in these states. Next, helping farmers. After independence, the India government has been trying to help farmers to increase agriculture production. So after our India become independence, then the India government, the government of India, they are trying to help the farmers in all states. They just try to help the farmers to increase their agriculture production, because with the help of farmer, we need all types of food. What we need, the in fact, all foods. What we eat, the all food, spices, even the rabi crops, kharif crop, everything, the food crop, the cash crop, whatever we are just going to eat, these all the farmers is going to provide us. So the government is what, they just trying to help all the farmers to increase their agriculture production. As we read earlier, many multi-purpose project has been built to supply water for irrigation. So as in the last chapter we have learned that the government has made the built that multi-purpose project, which they serve the, which multi-purpose project is what, which they helps, they serve one than more purpose. They are called multi-purpose. So dams are, there are different types of dams. Pakranangal dams, then the other dam is there, then Fakra Bangar Barrage dam is there, Nagarjuna Sagar. So different types of dam is there, multi-purpose project, which helps, it is built to whom? It is built to farmers, which it helps to the, to supply the water for irrigation. Now, farmers are being educated about the benefit of manure and organic fertilizers. So after that, the government has provided the farmer also that they can educate themselves in the farmers, in the agricultures, to the nature, to the fertilizers, and how to use them. And then he just explained that how they can use. Then after, the loan are provided to them so that they can buy modern agriculture tools and machine such as tractors. They also provide which better quality seeds. Then after, the government has given, started to give the loans to the farmers so that they can buy the modern types of agriculture tools like the machines, like tractors, and it can provide them the better quality of food seeds. So if they can start to growing the better quality of seeds foods, then we can get a better quality of food also. So that's why the government has decided to provide these all the facilities to the farmers, which helps in their agriculture. Now about the mineral resources, that we can see in the next classes. Agriculture, please read it, and mineral also you can read on your you have a lots of time, then you can read once again. Till that, take care of yourself. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.